Dear friends, welcome to this journey that tells about the first century Tamil land based on the periplus of Erythraean Sea. This presentation is based on the book named Travel and Trade in the Indian Ocean by a Merchant of the First Century by Wilfred H. Scoff. Today, we will see what Wilfred says about the ancient ship of Tamilagam, Sangara ship mentioned by Periplus. The first were, no doubt, the craft made of hollowed logs with planked sides and outriggers such as are still used in South India and Ceylon. The larger type, Sangara, were probably made of two such canoes joined together by a deck platform admitting of a fair-sized deck house. Dr. Taylor says that the name Jangar is still used on the Malabar coast for these double canoes. Caldwell gives the forms Changadam in Malayalam, Jangala in Tulu, and Sangadam in Sanskrit, a raft. Benfey derives it from the Sanskrit Sangara, meaning trade. Lassen, however, doubts the application of the word to shipping, and Heron ascribes the word to a Malay original. This is quite possible as the type itself is Malay and found throughout the archipelago. The comparatively large size of the shipping on the Coromandel coast is indicated also by the Andhra coinage, on which a frequent symbol is a ship with two masts, apparently of considerable tonnage. The maritime traffic to which the ship type bears witness is also attested by a large numbers of Roman coins which are found on the Coromandel coast. The shipping of the Andhra and Pallava coins doubtless survives in the modern Masula boats at Madras. Furnuos says, "The harbour of Madras can never be a harbour of refuge, and all that the works will secure is immunity for landing and shipping operations from the tremendous surf which is so general along the whole of Coromandel coast. Passenger traffic from the shore to the vessels is carried on by jolly boats from the pier or Masula boats from the shore. These latter are relics of a bygone day when Madras was an open roadstead, and when landing through the surf by any form of jolly boat was a matter extremely difficult, if not impossible. These Masula boats are flat-bottomed barges constructed of plank, sewn together with rope of coconut fiber, choked with aukum, and are able to withstand better than far more solidity built craft the shock of being landed on the sandy beach from the crest of a seething breaker." With this description of Sangara by Wilfred for the note in Erythraean Sea, I will meet you all with what this author had told about the Tamil vessel Kolandia in my next video. Until then, thanks for your support.